Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are fine. I am Pratima. I welcome you all to this video. And this is a video meant for class 7 students. I know some students have difficulties in division of decimals. So today we will discuss some questions so that it can be clarified. Only thing is, when you are dividing a decimal, the divisor must be a whole number, then it will be an easy one. So first we will convert the divisor into a decimal.
So I have taken a question from R.S. Agarwal book, exercise 3D, question number 7. It has 15 parts. So if you will go through the 15 parts and with me you will go on doing, then I hope you will understand and you will be very confident. Now divide 3.28 by 0.8. This is your first part of the question. So together you can write with me so that you can learn very quickly. So here what the trick is, first make this denominator as a whole number. So there is a decimal after, there is a digit after decimal. So I'll convert into whole number, I'll multiply 10. When I'll multiply 10, I'll multiply both in the numerator and denominator. So it will become how much? It will be 32.8, because decimal will shift to one place. And here it will be 8. You already know this. Now coming to division. So 32.8 division 8. Now it is very easy for you to divide. 8 fours are 32. Now decimal part is over, so I'll put a decimal, then 8 will come down, so 8 ones are 8. So what is the answer? Answer is 4.21. So we'll write the answer 3.28 division 0.8. the answer is how much? 4.1. next is second part, 0.288 divided by 0.9. Same procedure, make it 9. How to make it 9? I'll multiply 10. Here also multiply 10. The numerator will become 2.88 and the denominator will become 9. So decimal will shift to one place. So it will be 2.88 and this will be 9. Now divide 2.88. Now when we are dividing with whole numbers, you see 2 is smaller than 9. So first I'll put a 0 decimal, 0 point. Then I'll take into consideration of 28. So 28 divided by 9, it will be 3. So I'll put 3 now. 9 threes are 27. The 1 is brought down. Then 8 will come down. So 9 twos are 18. So the answer will be 0.03. So write the answer in a systematic way. So 0.28 divided by 0.9 is equal to how much? It will be 0.32. And for each division, you can multiply, you can check the answer also. Next is third part, 25.395 division 1.5. So I'll make it a whole number. There is one digit after the decimal, so let us multiply 10. How much I am getting now? 253.95, and here it will be 50. I hope you have understood. Now you can divide, you can check the answer from the screen when I'll do, when you, it is done, and pause the video so that you can be gradually feel that I am learning. So 253.95 division 50. So here there are 2 digits, so I'll take 2 digits together. Now 15, 1 jar 15. Now 5 minus 5, 0. 1 come down, 3. Next, recall the multiplication table of 15. 15, 6 are 90. And 15, 7 are 105, which is greater than your 103. So I'll go for 6. 15, 6 are 90. Then subtract. How much is this? 3. 10 minus 9. 1. Next, shall I bring 9 down? Yes, I'll bring it, but before that I'll put a decimal because whole number part is finished. So then I'll bring the 9 down. Next is 15, 7 are 105, 15, 8 are 120, 15, 9 are 135. So I'll put 16 point here, 9, 135. So what is the remainder? Remainder is 4. Now bring 5 down. So 15 threes are 45. I'm getting remainder 0. So no need of going further. So the answer is 16.93. So what I'll write? I'll write 25.395 division 1.5 is equal to 16.93. This is the answer of part 3. You got the same answer? Okay. Next, I'll go for part 4. So now I'll write 2.0484 divided by 0.18. Here there are two digits after the decimal. So I'll multiply with 100. I'll multiply with 100. 100 to make it a whole number. Then only I can divide. So how much it will be? Decimal will shift to two places. So this will be 204.84. And what will the denominator? It will be just 18. Now go on dividing. 204.84 division 18. 18, 1, 18, 2, 4, again 1, 18. 14 minus 8, 6. Next. Yes, I'll put a decimal here. So 8 will come down. Next is 18 twos are 26, 36, 18 threes are 54, 18 fours are 72. So I'll put 18 threes are 54. Now how much it will be? 4 and it is 1. Next last 4 will be brought down. So it will be 144. Now recall the table of 18. 18. 8 jar 144. 18 8 jar 144. So to be good in division, you should be good in multiplication table. So I got the answer. I'll write the answer. 2.0484 division 0.18. as answer is 11.38. Question number part 5. Now I hope you will do faster than me. So do and check the answer here. Be quick. 0.228 upon 0.38. So there are two numbers after the decimal. So I'll multiply it with 100. And in numerator, decimal will shift to two places. So it will be 228 divided by 38. Divide 228 divided by 38. So that the number is very big. So what to do? 38, 1 is 38. So you try with 38 with 6 or 7. Now why? because 7 threes are 21. It is near to this. So either do 6 or do 7. I think 7 will be more. It will be 236. So I'll multiply 6. 6 8s are 48, carries 4. 6 threes are 18, 4, 28. 6 8s are 48, carries 4. 16 threes are 18, 4, 22. Oh, exactly, you are getting the value. So how much it will be? 6. So this will be 2 to 8. So this question is very simple. So what is the answer? Answer is 0.228 division 0.38. The answer is 6. You got the same answer? Great. Next, sixth part. Sixth part is your, you can copy the question. Now, question is 0.08085 division 0.35. There are two numbers, so multiply with two numbers. Two numbers means two zeros with one. So it will be 80.85 divided by 35. Go on dividing. 80.85 divided by 35. 35 ones are 35. 35 twos are 70. Next, subtract. Remainder will be 10. Decimal part is over. So I'll put a decimal here. Then bring it down. 35 threes are 105. 35 threes are, you can check it. 35 threes are 105. So 35 threes are 105. So what is the remainder? 3. Then I'll bring 5 down. It is simple now. It will be 2.31. So I'll write the answer. 0.8085 division 0.35. Answer is your 2.31. Part 7. 7 is 21.976 division 1.64. How many digits are after decimal? It is 2. So I'll multiply with 100. Now shift two places. So it will be 2197.6 by 164. So it is a big number. But if you feel, you can cancel it with and make a smallest one. Then you can divide it. You can divide with these two numbers with 4. I'll go on doing. First, let me do the division because we are learning division. So 2197.6 division 164. So it is clearly visible that if I'll multiply 2, it will be 300 something. So I'll take by 1. 1 will go. 164 subtract 9 minus 4, 5. And this will be 11 minus 6, 5. Then 7 will come down. Next, 164, and this will be 500. So it cannot be more than 4 because 16 fours are 64. So I'll try for 3. 164, I'll try for 3. 4 threes are 12, carries 1. It will be 4, 9, 2. Check it again. So I'll put here 3 and 4, 9, 2. Subtract. Remainder will be 5 and it will be 6. Next is I'll put a decimal here. Then 6 will come down. Then it can be 4 because 4 is last digit. Here also unit place digit 4. Let us check for 4. 4 4s are 16. Carries 5. 4 6s are 24. No, I am not guilty. Yes, guilty. It will be 654. So 656. So the answer is 13.4. So the here I'll write. I'll write 21.976 division 1.64. Sorry, 1.64. Then answer is how much? 13.14. And the method I told you, first you cancel with 4, 4. The two numbers will be the less. Then it is easy for division. Next, I am going for 8. Question number part 8. 8 is 11.04 upon 1.6. So how many numbers are there after decimal? 1. So multiply with 1 and 10. So this will be 110.4 divided by 16. Divide it. 110.4 divided by 16. So here if I'll take 2 digits, it is smaller than 16. So I'll go for all the 3 digits. Now recall the table of 16. 16 fives are 80. 16 sixes are 96. 16 sevens are 112. So I'll go for 6. 16 sixes are 96. Subtract it. 10 minus 6, 4, and it will be 1. And I'll put decimal now because whole numbers are finished. Next, bring 4 down. So 16 nines are 144. 16 nines are. 16 nines are 144. So the answer is 6.9. So 11.04 division 1.6 is equal to 6.9 answer. Next. Next is 6.612 by 11.6. So I'll multiplying 10, we'll get 66.12, we'll get 116. Okay, go on dividing. 66.12 divided by 116. So this number is 66 is less than your 116. So first you'll put 0 decimal. Then we'll consider your 661. 661, 116 into 6 if I'll put, it will be greater than that. So I'll put it 5. 116 into 5. So this will be 5, 6 are 30, carries 3, 55, 58. It will be 558. So it will be 580. Now subtract 1, it will be 8. 2. Now how much? It will be 116. What should be multiplied? When it is 2, 7, check it. 116 into 7. Yes, I'm getting. So this will be 812 and the answer is 0.57. So let us write the answer now. 6.612 division 11.6 is equal to 0.57. Next, 10th part. 10th part is 0.0756 by 0.19. So there are two numbers I'll multiply by 100. I've learned it. So how much it will be? Decimal will shift here. So 7.6. 7.6 by, sorry, this will be 19. Divide. 7.6, 19. 7 whole number. 7 is less than 19. So I'll go for 0 point. Then it will be 76 together. So 19, 4s are 76. 19, pores are 76. So I got the answer in one step. So what is the answer? Answer is your 0.4. So 0.076 division 19, it will be how much? 0.0. 19 is equal to 0.4. This part is over. Next, 11. 11 is 148 division 0.074. So there are three digits after the decimal. So I'll multiply by 1000. 1000 divided by 0.074 into 1000. So it will become 148,000 by only 74. Divide 148,000 division 74. It is very easy. Just 2 will be the answer. And there will be how many zeros? 3 zeros. So what is the answer? Answer is 2000. So I'll divide this 148 division 0.074. The answer is 2000. Part 12. 16.578 divided by 5.4. There is one number after the decimal. So I'll multiply with 10. It will be 16.578 divided by 54. Now divide 165.78 divided by 54. So 16 is less than 54. So I'll go for three numbers together. Now 50 and this is 15. So first I'll try for 3. 54 into 3. It will be 3, 4 is 12, carries 1, 3, 16, 162. So I'll go for 3. 3, 1, 6, 2. How much is left? It will be 3. Now whole number is finished. I'm crossing the decimal. So I'll put a decimal here. Then 7 will come down. Still it is 37 is less than 54. So I'll put a 0 here. Then only I can bring 8 down. Now think of what should be there. 4, 7s are 28, so 8 will come last, so I'll try for 7. So let us see whether I'm getting 378 or not. 4, 7s are 28, carries 2, 7, yes, I'm getting. So 3, 7, 8, the answer is 3.07. So let me try the answer. 16.578 division 5.4 is equal to 3.07. So this is the answer. Next, third part. This is 13th part. 28 division by 0.56. So what should we multiply? 100, of course. So this will be 2800 by 56. Divide 2800 by 56. It will be how much? It will be, I think, 5. 5, try for 5. 5, 6 are 30, carries 3, 28. So another 0 is there. 0, so 0. So what is the answer? Answer is 50. So 2, this is 50. So this will be, I'll write 228 division 0.56 is equal to 50 is the answer. Okay, so I was telling to make it simplify, just I'm showing now. You can see here, this is another method of doing quickly. So what I'll do, you know that 28 twos are 56. So keep it 100 and this is 2. Then 100 by 2 is 50. So the answer is 50. No need of going for divisions. Then 14. 14 is 204 divided by 0.17. So this will be 204 0, 0 by 70. So what I did, I multiplied 100 in both the numerator and denominator. It will become 2, 4, 0, 4, 0, 0. It will become 70. Now divide 2, 0, 4, 0, 0 divided by 70. So 20 is more than 1. I can put 1, 17, 3, 4, 7, 2, 0, 34, 17, 2, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, then last 0, last 0. So what is the answer? Answer is 1200. So 204 divided by 0.17 is equal to 1200 answer. Next is 3 by 80. No need of multiplying anything. You will go dividing. 3 is less than 80. So I'll put a 0 point decimal. Then only I can take a 0 myself. So still it is less than 80. 30 is still less than 80. So I can put another 0. So it, I'll find it becomes 300. Now go for dividing. 300 into 80. How much it will be? 18 threes are 240. 18 into 3 is equal to 240. So I'll write 240. Then how much is left? 0. It will be 6. I can take a 0 because I have already put a decimal. I have right to put as many as 0 possible. Next is 80 into what multiplied? It will be less than 600. It will be 7. 560. If I'll take 7, 7 8 are 56. It will be 560. Next, what is the remainder? 40. I have put a decimal, so I can take as many 0 I require. So now it will be 5. So 85s are 400. So I can write the answer is 0.0385. So this will be 0.0375. So this is the answer. I'm writing 3 divided by 80 is equal to 0.375. Now 0.03. Now see, this I could have done in this way. What now I am doing, I'll not write 8. I'll write 3 by 8 into 10 here. Okay. And I'll divide 3 with 8. So this will be easier than this one because another 0, 0, I'm writing so many zeros. So what I'll do, if 3 is less than 8, so I'll put a 0 point. Then it will be a 0. 8 threes are 24. Then it will be 6. Again, I can put 0. 8 sevens are 56. 4, 0, 8 fives are 40. So answer I'm getting how much? I'm getting 3 by 8. I got 0.375. And I had already a 10 in the denominator. So decimal will be shifting to where? Decimal will shift to one place left. So what will the answer? It will be 0.0375. So when the numbers are big, you can also take in this way. You can 100 you can leave, and after the thing you can put the decimal. I hope you have enjoyed. Practice some more questions and don't forget to subscribe the channel so that you can learn more and more. You can develop your problem solving skills if you'll practice some more questions. Thank you.